Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel NCERT Maths with Pardeep. Today we are continuing our exercise number 11.3 of chapter 11, that is mensuration. So let's see our third question. Find the side of a cube whose surface area is 600 centimeter square. As we know that what is total surface area of a cube? This is 6a square, where A is the side. Okay, so what area is given to us? This is 600 centimeter square. That means 6A square should be equal to 600. So now what is A square? This 6 will go to other side. It will be divided. So now if you cancel, we will get 100. So this is A square is equal to 100. So what is A then? This is square root of 100. So what is square root of 100? As you already know, this should be 10 into 10. And what is A then? A is equal to 10 centimeter. So question is, what is the side? So you will write, therefore side is equal to 10 centimeters. So this is very simple question. Okay, so this is our question number 3. Now let's move on to the next question. So let's see the fourth question. Ruxar painted the outside of the cabinet of measure 1 meter by 2 meter by 1.5 meter. How much surface area did she cover if she painted all except the bottom of the cabinet? So length is 1 meter. So first is always length, second is width, and third one is height. So we need to find the total surface area of this cabinet minus bottom. So bottom is always, see, this L into B. So what is total surface area of the cabinet? That is 2 times LB plus BH plus HL. But we don't want the bottom. That is minus LB. Okay. So here, L is equal to 1 meter. What is B? 2 meters. And what is H? This is 1.5 meter. So how much area will she paint? Surface area to be painted. This should be equal to total surface area minus area of bottom. Right? So what is total surface area? This is 2 times LB plus BH plus HL minus area of bottom is length into width. So L into B, right? Let's put the values. L is 1, B is 2, then 2 into 1.5, 1.5 into 1 minus L into B, that is 1 into 2. So let's find the values. This is 2, 2 into 1.5 is 3. 1.5 as it is, minus 1 into 2 is 2. So 2 plus 3, 5. 5 plus 1.5 is 6.5 multiplied by 2 minus 2. Okay. So this will be 13 minus 2. That is 11 meter square. Okay. So area to be painted is equal to 11 meter square. So there is nothing difficult in this question. Only part is except the bottom. So how to find the bottom area? That is always L into B. So L into B we will subtract from the total surface area and we will be done with the question. Now let's move on to the next question. So let's see our fifth question. Daniel is painting the walls and ceiling of a cuboidal hall with length, breadth and height of 15 meter, 10 meter, and 7 meter respectively. From each can of paint, 100 meter square of area can be painted. How many cans of paint will she need to paint the room? Okay, so that means first we should find what is the total area that she will paint, and then we will see how many cans are required. Okay, first thing is we should note that she is painting the walls as well as ceiling. For walls we need lateral surface area, and for ceiling this is length into width. So let's see what is length. Length is first, that is 15 meter. What is width? This is 10 meter. What is height? This is 7 meter. Okay, so area painted is equal to area of walls plus area of ceiling. So what is area of walls? That we have already studied. This is lateral surface area plus area of ceiling. Okay, so what is lateral surface area of a cuboid? This is 2 times h l plus b, and area of ceiling is l into b, because whatever is the floor, same dimension ceiling is having, so this is also L into B. So let's put the values. This is H is 7, L is 15, B is 10, plus 15 into 10. So this is 14, 15 plus 10 is 25, plus 150. Okay, 25 fours is 100, so 25 and 10 is 35, so this is 350 plus 150, so total 500 meter square of area is to be painted. As we can see, one can cover 100 meter square. So to cover 500 meter square, how many cans are required? First we will write, since area painted by one can, this is 100 meter square. Okay, so number of cans required is equal to total area covered divided by area of one can. So this is total area over area painted by one can. So this is total is 500 over 100. So when we will cancel, so number of cans are 5. Okay, so this is our question number 5. I hope this question is clear. Now let's move on to the next question of the exercise. So let's see our sixth question. Describe how the two figures are alike and how they are different. Which box has larger lateral surface area? So we can see from the figure that what is the similarity? Both are 3D shapes. Okay, both are solid shapes. And both has same height. Okay, height of both is 7 cm. So there are two similarities. Number one is both are solid shapes or 3D shapes. Second is their height is same as 7 cm. And what is the difference? It is different because one is cylinder, other one is cube. And then we will find the lateral surface area of both and see which is larger. Okay, so here we can write similarities. Number one, both are solid shapes or 3D shapes. And number two, both has same height equal to 7 centimeters, and difference is one is cylinder and other one is cube. Okay, so now which has larger lateral surface area? So first we will find the lateral surface area of both and see which one is bigger. So for cylinder, what is R? See, this is diameter. Diameter is 7 centimeter. Then what is radius? This will be half of it. That is 7 by 2 centimeter. Okay? And height is 7 centimeter. So what is lateral surface area of cylinder? This is 2 pi RH. Okay? So 2 pi is 22 by 7. R is 7 by 2 and H is 7. So let's simplify this. The 7 and 7 will be cancelled. 2 and 2 will be cancelled. So 22 into 7. So 7 2s are 14. So 154 centimeter square is the lateral surface area of cylinder. So now let's find the lateral surface area of cube. So for cube, what is side? Side is 7 centimeter. So what is lateral surface area of a cube? This is 4a square, because we have to exclude ceiling and the floor. So this is 4a square. So 4 into 7 into 7. So 4 into 49. 9 4s are 36. 4 4s are 16 and 3 19. So this is 196 centimeter square. Okay. So the question was which has larger lateral surface area. So from the values 154 and 196, we can see that cube has more surface area. Therefore, cube has larger surface area. Correct? So this is our question number 6. This is all about this video. See you in my next video with the remaining questions of this exercise. Thank you.